With over 1,700 animals spread across 500 acres of land, Disney's Animal Kingdom theme park stands as Disney's largest theme park to date. As guests proceed through the front gate of the park, they immediately enter the Oasis Exhibits, a series of pathways that lead through a tropical forest filled with various types of animals, such as giant anteaters, exotic birds, tree kangaroos, and more. Oasis is one of seven themed areas within the Animal Kingdom, serving as the first attraction guests experience upon entering the park. The design of Oasis contains several animal habitats, resembling that of a typical zoo rather than a Disney theme park. Disney Imagineers use the Oasis exhibits to set up the premise of the park, yet also guard the guests from seeing the icon of the Animal Kingdom, the Tree of Life. When designing Disneyland California, Walt Disney explained that he wanted the guests to feel as if they were entering into a giant movie or a show when walking into his theme park. Barriers such as the Main Street train station or the Oasis exhibits serve as a type of curtain, as one would see in a theater, to their respective theme parks. The Oasis exhibits make the first impression of the Animal Kingdom a great transition from the normality of everyday life to the abundance of Disney magic within the park. Similar to the Magic Kingdom's Cinderella Castle, Epcot's Spaceship Earth, and Hollywood Studios' Sorcerer's Hat, the Tree of Life serves as the icon of the Animal Kingdom theme park. Standing at 145 feet tall and 50 feet wide at its base, the Tree of Life is no ordinary tree. The Imagineers felt that no single animal could represent the entirety of the park. Therefore, they decided that the icon must be a tribute to all of the different species of animals featured throughout the park. The Tree of Life has 325 animals carved into its trunk, along with a 4D attraction inside its massive base. When Imagineers decided to install an attraction into the base of the Tree of Life, using the characters from Disney Pixar's A Bug's Life appeared to be an obvious first choice, as insects seem highly likely to be living inside trees. The It's Tough to Be a Bug attraction is a 4D show, in which guests put on 3D bug-eye glasses to experience what it's like to be a bug. Imagineers didn't choose this attraction just based on the presence of insects and trees. The Animal Kingdom is attempting to portray a wide variety of animals that are present on our planet. Since insects represent close to 3/4 of the 1 million species of animals known to science, it seemed reasonable to not only acknowledge their existence, but to celebrate it in the center of the park. In addition to the attraction providing an entertaining experience with these creepy crawlers, it also demonstrates how insects play an active role in nature's overall circle of life.
As soon as you enter Dinoland USA, you're met face to face with Dino Zoo. Every guest that enters this part of Animal Kingdom takes the time to marvel at and take a picture with the skeleton of this long-extinct creature. That is exactly the goal that Disney Imagineers had in mind when creating Dinoland USA. They wanted guests of all ages to take time to ponder and appreciate the significance that dinosaurs once had on Earth, and to appreciate the significance that all animals in our world carry. A few steps after passing Dino Zoo, you enter Chester and Hester's Dinorama. This brightly colored section of Dinoland USA, where dinos with smiles from ear to ear walk around, represents dinosaurs in a kid-friendly manner and appeals to the much younger crowd. The cartoon-like representation of dinosaurs and Dinorama makes younger kids feel comfortable and interested in learning about creatures that generally frighten a majority of children. Guests are taught the comet theory of distinction of dinosaurs in the ride Triceratops Spin, where comets fly past the moving vehicle and dinosaurs pop up as the vehicle spins around. Everything in Dinorama is meant to be a fun and friendly representation of dinosaurs, which excites and welcomes young kids to enjoy themselves as children while learning about the lives and extinction of dinosaurs. The virtual ride, Dinosaur, is targeted at a significantly older audience than Dinorama. Because of the thrilling and somewhat startling nature of the ride, young children are restricted from the ride by a height requirement. Since the creators of the ride didn't have to worry about scaring young children off when creating the different aspects of the ride, dinosaurs are portrayed in a much more frightening and dangerous manner. Although this ride certainly does not represent dinosaurs in a friendly manner, older guests are intrigued and excited by the strength and power that the dinosaurs exude and are able to relive their curiosity and interest that they once had in dinosaurs as kids. This ride also provides an educational setting for learning about dinosaurs as well. Generally, most people stop learning about dinosaurs after they're in elementary school, and this ride allows an interesting and fun way for older people to learn about a subject that is generally targeted to younger children. By doing this, Disney promotes the idea that education about dinosaurs and animals in general should not be restricted to only childhood. Once you near the end of Dinoland, you finally come to the attraction of Finding Nemo the Musical. The Finding Nemo attraction attracts audiences of all ages. This brings different age groups together by showing that we all share similarities when it comes to the appreciation of animals. In the musical, the characters of the original movie and the actors of the musical are integrated by having the actors carry around elaborate illustrations of the characters on poles. By integrating the cast of the show with the animals of the story, the creators send out the important message that humans and animals share the world together. By showing the connection between animals and humans and Finding Nemo the Musical, the Imagineers show that not only are animals affected by the preservation of our environment, but humans are as well. By separating Dinoland into different age-specific parts, such as Dinorama and Dinosaur the Ride, the Imagineers suggest that the message that the impact that dinosaurs, and all animals for that matter, have had on our world is important to people of all ages. One of the top attractions in Asia is Expedition Everest. To get to the actual attraction, you have to first walk through the detailed village that is designed exactly like the foothills of the Himalayas. Once you arrive at the beginning of the line, the experience of a trekker begins. Disney wants its visitors to get the feel that they are actually going to be hiking a mountain. Of course, they must add in their own little twist of fantasy, as Disney always does. Pictures and guides inform the guests of the mountain's legend of the Yeti. This provides an air of intrigue to the guests, enhancing their imaginations and giving them a little something extra and unique to Disney. The way that the attraction is designed allows visitors to become fully immersed in this fantasy. It is enhanced by the Yeti's footprints in the mountain and comes to a dramatic climax once the Yeti pops out and growls at riders, echoing throughout the mountain. After leaving the attraction, you realize that you can't see the switch from forwards to backwards from the ground, which allows the surprise to fully catch riders off guard, adding to the thrill of the experience. Making your way off of the ride, you arrive at the Yak and Yeti restaurant, which is fully decorated with Asian influences and statues. Disney is smart to include themed restaurants to ensure that no matter where you go in the park, you never leave the sensation that you are actually visiting that particular continent. Visitors feel as if they are actually in Asia without having to fly across the Atlantic. It provides an experience that fits any generation in the family, something that going to the actual country does not always offer. Sometimes while visiting other countries, it is difficult to please every age group. In Animal Kingdom, however, Disney succeeds in providing an experience suited for each member of the family. The second major attraction is the River Rapids ride, which Disney subtly uses to educate people about the burning of rainforests by man. In the slower areas of the ride, you pass by the torched logs of broken down trees and remains of a rainforest. Fires blaze as you float by, which catches the attention of guests while also informing them. Especially since these attractions appeal more toward children, Disney seizes the opportunity to raise awareness in younger generations that will grow up to make a difference. Also, the parents that accompany their kids will become informed on the topic if they were not previously aware. Without taking the fun out of the experience, Disney finds a way to make the attraction educational yet informative to its visitors.
Walking into Africa at Disney's Animal Kingdom, you will enter through the village of Harambe, meaning come together in Swahili. Here you can truly understand what it's like to be in Africa. Native Africans dressed in authentic costumes work here to add to the atmosphere. Disney highlights the history, economic, and political status of the continent through the detailed architecture. With whitewashed walls, thatched rooftops, acacia trees, and tall grasses, tourists can get a sense of what African landscape is truly like. The crumbling old buildings and huts found throughout this community were built by South African craftspeople. Traders walk around the marketplace offering carvings, jewelry, and souvenirs. This is unlike other parks who sell Disney souvenirs and stuffed animals. This highlights that Disney's idea for Africa and Animal Kingdom is for people to feel as though they are really part of a special experience. Disney is the first to build a real-life African savanna and does so by adding over 4 million plants and featuring 3,000 different species. Kilimanjaro Safari Ride is the attraction spotlighted in this area of the park. The bumpy safari jeep ride focuses audience on the story that there is a poacher present and trying to catch elephants. This story, along with the bumpy ride, is why the Kilimanjaro Safari is so thrilling. You will find animals native to Africa roaming the 100 acres of rivers, hills, and grasslands. Part of Disney's magic is secretly blending barriers into the landscape for safety purposes. The invisible barriers look natural and are hard to see when riding past them. You know that the barriers work because you will never see animals attacking each other or you. This allows riders to feel comfortable around animals, giving people a chance to feel as though humans and animals can interact together in harmony. The journey ends at Pangani Forest Exploration Trail, where tourists can continue to see different types of animals as they walk through the bamboo jungle. Disney leaves riders off here to ensure that everyone gets to see all kinds of animals. If tourists were left off at a restaurant or shop, they might not have the immediate chance to keep observing all the different species. Disney also wants people to continue feeling as though they are in Africa by traveling through jungles and exploring the forest. Disney uses this attraction to show tourists how animals are treated with respect. Birds fly freely throughout the area, and endangered gorillas reside here in a safe and comfortable environment. This instills into people's mind that at Disney's Animal Kingdom, the mission is to keep animals safe and ensure that the workers treat the animals with respect. The Wildlife Express Train is the only way to travel from Africa to Rafiki's Planet Watch. This takes riders directly past the Animal Housing and Care Center. The fact that you can only get to Rafiki's Planet Watch one way, which leads past these care centers, proves what Disney's goals are for Africa. Disney wants people to have a once-in-a-lifetime experience by coming in close contact with unique animals from all over the world, but also realize that animals in the Animal Kingdom are treated with respect. Disney hopes this theme rubs off on people so that when they leave the park, not only do they have a magical experience, but they learn how to treat wildlife the right way.
Without the Disney magic, Animal Kingdom would be perceived as just another zoo, when in fact it is really a celebration of all animals. The fact that these two themes are blended attract both theme park visitors and zoo lovers alike, giving them the best of both worlds. This celebration of all animals is brought together at Rafiki's Planet Watch and Conservation Station. Here guests can see the backlot tour of how animals are cared for, including the animal houses and care facilities. There are many educational stations to learn about conservation in many fun and hands-on ways, giving children one-on-one interaction. By doing so, Disney is teaching through experience rather than by telling, which in turn has a stronger impact on learning. Disney also provides a level of transparency in this section. By having this transparency, Disney is also showing that sometimes magic can't be artificially created and the real magic is pure and natural. This further engages guests in first-hand learning that leaves a lasting impact on them that they could bring out of the park and into the real world. Continuing around the main circle of Animal Kingdom, guests are directed towards Camp Mnnie-Mickey. Here the animal world of the park meets the imaginary world of the beloved Disney characters. The blending of realities is done so with character greetings and life-size figurines of the Disney characters intertwined with lush landscape. These characters are all enjoying nature, which is showing younger guests to love nature and to get outside and enjoy it. Camp Mnnie-Mickey's location is strategically placed in the park. It is located close to the exit as a tactic to keep guests in the park as long as possible. After a long day of seeing and experiencing the park, many adults just want to head out. However, with Camp Mnnie-Mickey being on the way out, it entices children to want to stay in and see their favorite characters, because no Disney trip is complete without them. This then leads to an increase in photo, souvenir, and food sales.